recently I've seen a lot of people talking about a few different intersecting discussions about gender and dogs online. I wanted to join that discourse. First, a few caveats. I'm obviously a straight, white, male-presenting person. My opinion, I think, probably shouldn't matter nearly as much as the opinions of people that are being actively hurt by others who are trying to erase their existence. I don't know if anyone will see this, and that's okay. For those of you who do watch this, thank you for supporting all of our animal rescue efforts. Second, I hope that by the end of this, you realize that you are beautiful, amazing, wonderful, just the way you are, and you don't need to hold yourself to unrealistic standards. Now, if you'll indulge me a little, there is a point to this next part. When you look at a dog, do you wonder or care about their gender? Can you tell the gender of this dog just by looking at them? What about this dog? If you know our dogs already, then you might already know their genders, but often people will guess, and very often people will guess incorrectly. We don't correct people when they get our dogs or cats' genders incorrect. When we use the correct gender in a sentence to describe the dog or cat, people always apologize and correct themselves. People will sometimes entirely change their compliments to match the new gender and perceived corresponding gender identity of the dogs. The question that remains is fairly simple. Why can't people have the same respect for other people? In reality, our dogs do not care if you call them handsome or pretty. Our cats will still judge you the same whether you call them by he, she, they, or it. We can never actually know how dogs and cats perceive gender or whether they care at all.
Yes. 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 Come here.
It is our heteronormative human understanding of gender that we place on them. In nature, there are numerous examples from multiple species of birds, fish, mammals, reptiles, and amphibians that will change genders or perform homosexual acts for various reasons that are well outside the scope of this video. If you want more reading material, I've included some sources in the description below. Our understanding of gender and sexuality is very socially influenced by human interpretation and not based on any universal fact. Gender, especially the expression of gender to others, is not the same as an individual's physical sex. Gender is the thing that some people have difficulty understanding. If, for example, dogs started speaking tomorrow and were able to communicate that they were all non-binary and did not adhere to the idea of being male or female, would we collectively cancel dogs? Or would we agree that they are allowed to just be themselves? I prefer to allow my dogs to be themselves. They can sniff butts, roll in the dirt, bark at squirrels, chase burbs, do anything else that their instincts and feelings tell them that they like. We as people grant dogs freedom to express themselves however they like without placing gendered bias on them. Of course, there are many gendered interpretations of how dogs should behave, like alpha dog theory, which is an entirely different video discussion that has been debunked numerous times. The main point is that our current understanding of dogs and dog training has attempted to remove this gendered bias and give dogs the space they deserve to be themselves regardless of gender. The remaining question then is, why don't we give people the same freedom to express themselves? This channel has been dedicated to the betterment of dogs and cats. Every video is intentionally framed from our dog's or cat's perspective. My intention is to frame the videos so that our dogs and cats, and animals in general, can be seen as deserving the same respect that people have. That is not to say that we think dogs and cats are in fact people or to personify them. However, dogs and cats do have their own emotions, physical needs, and mental understanding of the world around them. By attempting to frame our videos around the perspective of our pets, I hope to make it easier for people to see all animals as deserving of respect and kindness. This channel was never meant to be about me or my partner. However, the longer I volunteer in the animal rescue world, the more obvious it becomes that many of the problems that come up are due to people's understanding and interpretation of how pets should behave. It is the human understanding of animals as pets and the human understanding of gender that needs to change in order to make all of our lives better. Finally, I'd like to talk about Pride Month, which I think is an amazing and necessary celebration of the differences between people, to be absolutely clear. This video has taken me a lot longer to make than I had originally hoped, but I also think that being a good ally to all minority groups means that I need to speak out and advocate for them as often as possible.
Editing note, I don't think my intention was fully clear, so I want to emphasize that I'm not intending to center myself in this argument because I don't want this to be about me. I earnestly do want to be supportive. I feel as if I am still an outsider, so to speak, and I don't want to impose myself on others. That happens too often as it is. Further, if someone is attending a pride event or other LGBTQ-friendly event and obviously causing harm, they have no right to be there. That goes for any other minority spaces as well. No one should feel harassed or fearful from another person forcing their way into a space that is not meant for them. For myself, I hope to be included in more diverse spaces for reasons which I hope will become clear with the following statements.
That being said, one of the discussions that I saw come up a lot this year was that bisexual people should not bring their straight partners, mostly bisexual girlfriends, bringing their straight white male golden retriever boyfriends to pride events. I'm speaking only for myself, but there are a few important caveats before I continue. My partner and I are straight. This is not a coming out video for myself, and I can't speak for my partner. They are their own person. I'm using non-gendered language on purpose, not to invoke outrage or imply anything, just to make the point that pronouns are part of language. We do still celebrate and try to be supportive of pride. For myself in the past, it was solely because I felt it was important to celebrate diverse voices and learn about other people's experiences. However, over time, by being given the space to evaluate myself, I have accepted that I have never really fit into the normative masculine presentation. I have always been labeled overly sensitive, different, or strange. I don't generally fit the classic stereotype of what a man is, especially in some circles online. And as you can see, I'm leaning into that a little more now. This is not just based on my own feelings of not fitting in, but also on the bullying I've received for most of my youth. Not something I've done intentionally to try and be different or unique, it's just how I end up presenting myself. Instead of struggling to fit in or change myself, especially as I have gotten older, I have been given to the space to explore who I want to be as a person. I believe that all people should have this same freedom to define who they are and who they want to be. I will not claim any level of queerness for myself. I recognize that I am in a privileged position to even be able to speak on this topic with fairly minimal backlash. I have learned to be comfortable with who I am and how I want to be. I like painting my nails, it gives me joy. I'm not afraid to have long hair, even though several people, mostly in real life, have commented about how it's not normal for my hair to be this long. I define what being a man is for myself. I can choose to respect the people around me, listen to other people, help those in need, stand up against bullies, and be the best version of myself that I can be. All of this has only been possible because other people have created a safe place for people to express their own gender identities. I have followed many people online that I will also list below to learn about their experiences. Listening to others has allowed me to see the wonderful diversity of other people and how they see the world. I can identify with many of them, but I find that my own experience is still unique. I think everyone's experience is unique. I ask that the LGBTQ+ community welcomes people like me that try to be supportive from the outside. Everyone should be free to be who they are, and that's only possible when we break down and reevaluate gender norms for everyone. Gender does not have to be a binary solution if that's not what fits you as an individual. Gender can be fluid, men can be feminine, women can be masculine. There are traits people view as masculine or feminine that all people have inside of them. In the end, if dogs, cats, and animals have the freedom to be themselves, people should too. Ultimately, if you love and respect animals, you should be able to extend the same feelings to the people around you. If you're able to use the correct pronouns for a dog or a cat, then you should be able to do so for a person. Thank you for watching. Remember to spay and neuter your pets, and please be kind to animals and people. Goodbye, T.